Welcome back, friends. My previous video on Google BERT architecture explanation is liked very much. While BERT is so popular, there have been so many upgrades to BERT to overcome its limitations. Yes, BERT also had some limitations. For example, it is limited to small number of sentences. So community is working hard to overcome with improvements, which include transformer, XL, XLNet, etc., etc. There are GUGA and etc. also coming in. So today we are going to talk about XLNet. XLNet, in this term, XLNet means extra long. First of all, the full form of XLNet is Generalized Autoregressive Pretraining for Language Understanding. We'll talk about these terms while explaining the XLNet. So the extra long word is derived from transformer XL. So XLNet is actually came after transformer XL. XLNet achieved state-of-art results on 18 tasks, which include question answering, natural language inference, sentiment analysis, document rendering, etc., on which BERT also performed well, but XLNet has performed better than that. XLNet integrate ideas from transformer XL, the state-of-art autoregressive model, into its pre-training. Let's talk about why the XLNet kind of methods are needed. I'll suggest you to go through my video on BERT, where I have explained many terms like mass language modeling and all. In MLM, artificial symbols like MASK, you can see this MASK, are used by BERT during pre-training, which are actually not present in the real world data during fine-tuning, when you train them on your downstream task, which results in a pre-train fine-tuned discrepancy. Whatever was pre-trained and what results are coming during the fine-tuning, so there comes a discrepancy due to absence of these mass tokens. Also, BERT assumes the predicted tokens are independent of each other given the unmasked tokens, but it does not happen in real world. In real world, natural language, words are dependent on the distance words two in sentences, right? For example, if I'm talking, actually I'm making a context from the word which I uttered in very early in the sentence, right? So that also creates a issue in the BERT. So these are the BERT issues that I was trying to bring your focus. Now let's talk about what are the ingredients, what are the components of XLNet. So XLNet actually employs two specific techniques called as permutations. When you have a sentence which contains say 4 or 5 tokens, it creates a permutation combination of all the words or say tokens into the sentence and feeds to the model. So this is a permutation. The number of permutations are of their factorization order, 4, 3, 2, 1, like that. And other technique is used is autoregression. XLNet is a autoregressive model. So let's talk about what autoregression kind of stuff is. There are multiple type of language modeling being adopted by community. One kind is autoregressive and one kind is autoencoders. As I explained in the previous video as well in BERT, that BERT is autoencoder or encoding decoding kind of mechanism, whereas XLNet uses autoregression. If you have worked with the time series models, you must have heard of ARIMA, where in ARIMA, AR stands for autoregressive. So ARIMA, XLNet, these are kind of autoregressive models. What autoregressive is? The term autoregression indicates that it is a regression of the variable against itself. The other models researched by community which use autoencoders, which have used permutation techniques like neural auto regressive distribution estimation and mass autoencoders for distribution estimation, but they are not order aware. XLNet is order aware with positional encoding. That's an extra feature. We'll talk about how it is order aware and all. More stuff that has been added in XLNet so that it is an upgraded version and it is giving more accuracy is reparameterize the transformer to avoid the ambiguity which arises due to arbitrary. When you feed the tokens in a permutation way, in an arbitrary way to the transformer, it creates ambiguity. So what it does is it reparameterizes the transformer by giving it a positional encodings. so that transformer is aware which token actually lies where. It also uses two more techniques, segment recurrence mechanism and relative encoding scheme of the transformer XL. These are specific to transformer XL. We can talk about them when we are talking about transformer XL. Now you have understood some basic things about how XLNet is working, how BERT is working. Now let's get into some maths. But before I get into the maths, I believe let's split this video into two parts. In the next video, which will be the final, where we are going to talk about the differences between XLNet and BERT, how you can use XLNet in Python for training and getting the sample output. So see you guys there.